Hey guys, here's another episode of Day in the Life of Vintage Classic Specialist. Today is a Wednesday, which normally means that Rafa would be here. Unfortunately, Rafa was not feeling well this morning, and so he took the day off sick. He was kind of starting to cough the past couple days, so I wasn't really surprised. Hope he gets better soon, and so there you go. So it was me solo today, the one arm mechanic, with my balloon looking hand. So getting done what I can do with one hand, basically. So a couple things happened today. One is started assembling the motor for the Ghia, for the 71 Ghia. Made quite a bit of progress considering I was doing it with just one hand. The generator is not quite mounted up yet. I like to kind of dry assemble things, mock things up, and then do final assembly. Haven't put the fan on it yet, but you know, just kind of checking how things fit. But other than that, other than the fan shroud and the generator, the carburetor is just sitting here. Everything below that is pretty much mounted up. Actually, I take that back. The exhaust is just sitting there at the moment. Again, kind of dry fitting things, and found a bit of an issue here. Not quite sure how I'm gonna address that yet. I started trying to tweak this pipe to line up. It actually looks like if it were to just swing kind of that way, it might line up, but yeah, we'll see. I don't know. I'm not super happy with this manifold. I may try a different one and see how that goes. But other than that, you know, it's always something with these motors, and especially with replacement parts, you know, it's kind of hit and miss sometimes. But the good news is everything else is looking really good. The paint on it that I did yesterday came out pretty nice, I think. Starting to put on these zinc plated parts that we had done in gold zinc look really good. We even went ahead and redid the original hose clamps, which are much nicer than the kind of more modern type of hose clamps that just look ugly. These are original ones. They even have Volkswagen stamped on them. It's too bad it's not going to show, but I just love finding Volkswagen logos on original parts. There they are on these. So yeah, trying to reuse the original stuff when we can, because it looks bitchin' and quality, can't beat it. So yeah, pretty good progress on this today. The flywheel didn't get machined. I'm gonna probably go ahead and pull it off and send it out to a machine shop that we use and have them resurface it. It actually looks pretty nice, which is why our long block builder didn't do it. But you know, at this point, to me, it just makes sense to go ahead and machine that surface. We're putting a new clutch disc, obviously, new pressure plate. So let's just make everything new and do it right. So that is about it for what I was able to get done on the motor today. Again, more or less operating with one hand here. So let's talk about the Ghia itself. So the Ghia did have a lot of progress on it today. So I mentioned we were going to have our paint guy that we use go ahead and paint the engine compartment. And he did that, came out really good. Underneath the deck lid, also looking really good. We didn't bother so much with the firewall there, because that's going to get the stock kind of sound deadening material that goes on it. But everything else here is pretty much going to show. So it's painted looking really nice. The wheel wells are supposed to have a kind of sound deadening material on them. Not sure if we're going to put it on or not. I think it's going to look kind of good without it. We'll put on these side pieces that kind of fill in this area over here. These, not sure about this, 100% will be going in. So yeah, huge improvement on this car. So that ugly green that was there in the engine compartment's gone. And then likewise, luckily I'm thin, so I can squeeze through this narrow spot. Same thing up front here. The green is gone, thank goodness, so ugly. So yeah, looking beautiful now. Our paint guy that we use Save-On paint supplies in Garden Grove. The guy out there, Jesus, is the one who does the paint matching. This guy is a total wizard. the color is like dead on with the original paint. I took him the gas filler door, and he matched the paint. Really good job. I mean, I don't think you would ever guess this was matched paint. It's pretty much dead on. Anyway, so I'll probably let this dry for another day or so, and there may be some little touch-up areas that he has to do. But overall, this is pretty much done. So once I give this another day or two to dry, the good news is then I can start wiring. So the original harness is still in there. Just kind of cut it back. I'll use that harness to pull the new one through there. Can start putting the brake reservoir in and run its lines and stuff. You know, I waited on all that stuff until the painting was done. It didn't make any sense to do any of that, but now all that can be done. The front hood is also been painted up on the underside. It had a crack in the sheet metal around one of the hinge mounts, so we fixed that. And then it also had this kind of weird bow in it, where instead of following the contour of the body right here, it actually almost kind of sunk down a little bit. So our paint and body guy straightened that out too. So it's going to be fitting much, much better now. And yeah, so it's exciting. This is kind of like one of the last big things to do on this car before it just really starts going together for full-on assembly. Now that that's all painted, we can go ahead and start working on the dash as well. Put in the wood panel, the faux wood panel, the upper pad, lower pad. Yeah, start thinking about putting the carpet in it. Put the windows back in. Motor will be done. So yeah, this car should come together pretty fast now. Again, the paint was kind of holding up some other things, but now that the paint is basically done, you know, essentially very little standing in the way other than the fact that I only have one hand of this car coming together. So that's it for today, guys. I'd say it was a decently productive day given the fact that, again, I'm pretty much operating with one hand. I'm pretty happy with what I was able to get done. And very pleased to have got this paint done here on the Ghia finally, because that opens the door to doing a lot of more things on it. I will mention just briefly, our longtime customer of the shop, a gentleman named Mike, brought in his very beautiful early 60s Beetle today for a handful of things that we're going to do. I will probably go ahead and do a separate walk around video of this car, because it deserves it, most certainly deserves it. This is a really, really bitchin', super clean car. Our shop has done a lot of work on it in the past, and he's bringing it in for us to give it some more TLC, number of things. Again, I'll do a separate video on this car here in the next couple days. So in the meantime, that is it for tonight, guys. Thanks for watching. We will see you next time.